Hi guys, welcome to schoolaa, your online school. Do you know how to draw all the structural isomers for C6H12? Please watch the video to be surprised by the number of isomers I can draw. To draw all the possible structures for C6H12, we should take into consideration that it applies the general formula of CnH2n, so it can be an alkene or it can be a cycloalkane. So I'm going to draw all the possible structures for alkenes and cycloalkanes with the general formula C6H12. I will start by drawing 6 carbon atoms chains alkenes with a double bond at the first carbon, like this. We call it 1-hexene. The double bond can be at the second carbon, like this, and we call it 2-hexene. It can be at the third carbon, like this, and we call it 3-hexene. Can we have the double bond at the fourth carbon? No, it's not possible, because we're going to start numbering from the right side, and then it's going to be called 2-hexene. And this is not an isomer because we have this name on another structure. What if we start drawing 5 carbon atoms chain alkenes with the double bond at the first carbon? Since we cannot place the methyl at the first and the last carbons, so we end up with 3 possibilities. Either to place the methyl at the second carbon, like this, and it's going to be called 2-methyl-1-pentene. Or we can add the methyl at the third carbon, and the name is going to be 3-methyl-1-pentene. Or we can add the methyl at the fourth carbon, and its name is going to be 4-methyl-1-pentene. What if we start drawing pentene with a double bond at the second carbon? And also here, since we cannot add the methyl at the end carbons, we end up with 3 possibilities. Either the methyl at the second carbon, like this, and this is going to be called 2-methyl-2-pentene. If we add the methyl at the third carbon, it's going to be called 3-methyl-2-pentene. And also if we add the methyl at the fourth carbon, it is called 4-methyl-2-pentene. And since we cannot have 3-pentene, let's start drawing 4 carbon atoms alkenes, like this one with a double bond at the first carbon. Always keep in mind that we cannot add the substituents at the end carbons. So here we end up with 2 possibilities. Either we add the substituent at the second carbon or at the third carbon. In this isomer, we have 1 methyl at the second carbon, 1 methyl at the third. So it's going to be called 2,3-dimethyl-1-butene. Let's try to draw the 2 methyls at the same carbon, which is the third carbon, like this. This one's going to be called 3,3-dimethyl-1-butene. Let's see if we can add the 2 methyls to the second carbon, like this. It's not possible, since carbon cannot make more than 4 bonds. Is it possible to add an ethyl substituent to the third carbon? Let's see. In this case, the longest chain is going to be pentene, and the name is going to be 3-methyl-1-pentene, and this is not an isomer, since we get this name earlier. Let's see if we add an ethyl substituent to the second carbon, like this. Then the name is going to be 2-ethyl-1-butene. Let's try to put the double bond at the second carbon and butene. So we're going to have only one possibility, with 2 methyls, one at the second carbon and one at the third carbon, like this. And its name is going to be 2,3-dimethyl-2-butene. And I think that's it regarding alkenes. I could draw 13 isomers with the formula C6H12. If you could draw more isomers that I didn't mention, please write me a comment. And now I'm going to start drawing cycloalkanes with the formula C6H12. For sure, I'm going to start with 6 carbon atoms ring, which is called cyclohexane. Then we can draw 5 carbon atoms ring with a methyl group, and this is going to be called methyl cyclopentane. And now let's start by drawing isomers of cyclobutane with 4 carbon atoms ring. What if we have 2 methyls at the same carbon? Then its name is going to be 1,1 dimethyl cyclobutane. What if we have 2 methyls at 2 adjacent carbons? Like this, its name is going to be 1,2 dimethyl cyclobutane. What if we have the methyls at 2 opposite carbons, like this? Then its name is going to be 1,3 dimethyl cyclobutane. And the last possibility is when we have an ethyl group joined to the cyclobutane, and its name is going to be ethyl cyclobutane. And finally, let's start drawing isomers of cyclopropane. Like here, we have cyclopropane with 3 methyl groups located at different carbon atoms. Its name is going to be 1,2,3 trimethyl cyclopropane. If we have 2 methyl groups at 1 carbon and 1 methyl at the second one, then its name is going to be 1,1,2 trimethyl cyclopropane. And if we have 1 ethyl and 1 methyl groups joined to 2 different carbons, then the name is going to be 1 ethyl 2 methyl cyclopropane. If we have the ethyl and the methyl joined to the same carbon, then its name is going to be 1 ethyl 1 methyl cyclopropane. And if we have a propyl substituent joined to a cyclopropane, the name is going to be propyl cyclopropane. One last isomer. When we have isopropyl group joined to cyclopropane, the name is going to be isopropyl cyclopropane. So as you could see, we could draw 25 different structural isomers for C6H12. I hope that you liked this video. If you could have an isomer that I didn't mention with a different name, please write me a comment. If you still find it difficult to differentiate between straight and branched alkanes, or how to name different alkanes, alkenes, or alkynes, or how to draw all the possible isomers, please check the description for useful links, and good luck. And now you are ready to solve the end of video questions. Please, if you are not, repeat the video again. Otherwise, solve the questions. Put your answer in the comment section. If you have any question that I didn't cover in the video, please share it with me in the comment section. Share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel to stay tuned for more videos. See you in other videos, and good luck.